relationship, so I'd come out of one and go straight into another relationship. I've never had time to be on my own and just enjoy it.
Wait, you're more drunk if you do it with no hands.
Dos San Miguel, por favor.
Oh my god.
I haven't learnt how to say vodka yet. Depends my inner being.
Don't mind having a quick massage while you're at it.
Hello, it's
It's always something, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Too skinny, too fat, fake boobs. They want something to write about, fair enough, but not every single week. It gets boring.
Okay, to God.
Cow. I hate feeling rushed like this.
I could see my door getting wider open, right? And I was like, oh, this is what I've been waiting for. This is what I am afraid of.
It's a long day as it is, but it's a fucking long day because the whole thing's going on the
field.
It was the worst 40 minutes of my life.
Good night.
Welcome party was great from you guys.
I have had to come with a thong as a bauble because
I told you to look for one.
Totally unprepared.
And you and so. One somewhere now.
This is what we've got. Now,
yeah.
Wipe that from the record.
It's just nice, just to be nice and polite and just everything runs a lot more smoother then.
Come on, get that on camera. There's three of them.
They are gorgeous.
I've got my bikini top on.
But it ain't coming off.
Bye, Tom. I know this is off the cuff.
Hi, I'm Kimberly and I'm from Bradford.
I bruise like a peach.
And then I look and I've just seen him up there. Stood there brazen, wasn't he? Those lenses are pretty big.
Pop music and it's entertaining and it's fun and it's all it needs to be, really.
Wherever I go delayed, all drama follows.
Because we've been in here since 9 o'clock this morning. It's now 9 o'clock at night. It's not normal.
I think I'm quite feisty.
My dad always tells this story to every boy that I meet, right? When I was younger, I've always picked my nose.
If we were doing what we would do, you would see us in our true light and what we would do as people, not as puppets.
Look how embarrassing this is.
It's ridiculous.
I tried to eat healthy, but actually doesn't. And I'm under strict instructions. He wants biscuits.
From what Ashley, it's 10 times worse. I think I get it bad and he gets stopped like every other footstep.
Get it?
Yeah. Thank
you. Thanks.
Thanks.
People say I've had a boob job done, you know, and I haven't.
Why did I say that?
That's the pictures that sparked the rumours. I can actually say why. It's a bit embarrassing. Oh, horrible.
Everybody says that. I mean, that seems to be... I don't know where it originally got written, but it's sort of...
What, me boobs?
Yeah, people think that's sort of common knowledge.
Do they?
Yeah, I've heard it anyway.
Hey, did you think I had them done?
I didn't. I had no idea, did I?
But you would just believe it, wouldn't you, if people are writing it? And I was on some programme one time, my dad rang us up. Instead of just seeing on, celebrity surgery or whatever it is, and they go through who's had surgery. I mean, it's quite flattering, isn't it? You've got to take it as a compliment. It's not a bad thing, necessarily, so I don't mind. I can see it if they want. It just means I've got a good pair. I'm not going to start doing drastic cosmetic surgery. Fair enough, if I'd had 3 kids and then all of a sudden my boobs were up there, poop, I could understand why they were saying it, but I'm a young girl, I've got natural boobs.
Frankie, you nearly ready?
Hopefully, we won't get skanked.
And we'll walk in, there'll be no one there. I hate feeling rushed like this.
The ringles at the hotel ringles are
that last.
I'm not upset.
Thank you. Right, there you go.
Thank you,
right.
You
ready?
Right,
get your home.
Oh, that's great. That's nice.
Okay, Ed Wild, what are you doing? Well, let's do this. We're all done. Why are we waiting?
Standing by, ready to go. Positions, please, girls. Here we go. Playback and turn over, please. Thank you, board.
Nine.
We're just watching ourselves on the screen and we're really impressed.
Quite pleasantly surprised.
There are little bits where we occasionally
just do it
on a little bit
of maximum where the track
yeah, but when you do a few takes, there'll be the, like, little bits where we like laugh it off and carry on, and there's always going to be good bits they can get. But like the majority of it's really,
it's quite good.
Really, I'm pretty chuffed.
Impressed.
It's like someone else inside.
Are we back
squad
on this?
It's not me.
Well, we were just sitting here. And I seen this man walking, and I thought he might just be, like, walking, you know, as they do. And then I seen him sit in the tree, and then I seen this big, massive lens. And I was like, girls, run for cover. Paparazzi in the bushes.
When Nicola said it, I thought, no, she's winding me up. She knows that I'll be devastated. And then I looked, and I just seen him up there. Stood there brazen, wasn't he? Staring, he wasn't even hiding very well.
The next thing you know about it is when it's in the paper and you're looking at yourself and it's stalkerish. You think you're like a stalker, only everybody's seeing your picture. It's disgusting, you know, it's the home in on your private parts and stuff. It's just disgusting.
Have you got to do anything?
Do you guys know anything about the venue where you're playing tomorrow?
No idea. I know it's called Eden.
That's it.
And I know that we're doing half an hour set.
I don't know, I'll find out,
That's all what I know.
Hi, chicks.
Hiya.
How you doing? Alright.
Hiya.
Not me, I'm a baby.
How you doing?
I'm John. Pleased to meet you.
I'm Nadine.
Yeah, obviously. Met the other four, you're the one who's best, isn't it? Ladies and gentlemen, we have Girls Aloud in the house! We're very privileged people to have these ladies in Ireland for the first time, and especially even more privileged to have them here down live at Holly FM Ibiza. Ladies, welcome to Ibiza. How are you feeling?
Good.
Excellent, excellent. So how do you feel about performing here?
Well, it's a little bit scary, really, to be honest.
Why is that?
Because it's known as the Rivers Capital, isn't it? Really?
There's all sorts of music here. I mean,
yeah,
basically...
But
dance. And you're what?
Huh? We're
not dance,
pop
dance,
at its
dance,
best.
Dance.
Exactly. So what are you?
Pop at its best.
Pop at its best. I'm looking forward to loud music, I'm looking forward to big crowd, lots of energy, and you lot going for it on the stage, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah? You promise?
Yes.
Okay. Just don't get us too mullered downstairs when we watch the sunset.
We'll Listen, we're watching the sunset, we're going to get battered. Do you know why? Because I've got a crate of cold crystal waiting for you.
Oh.
And no matter what.
Maybe we'll have to say that.
Listen, £400 a bottle, man, even if you don't like it, you just drink it anyway. Yeah? You know, it's all part of the fun. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, get there very early because it's going to be a packed night one way or another. Full stage, full live rig, and of course, the ladies themselves. Girls Aloud, round of applause, please. You all right with that? You've been strong.
Give me a little vodka Red Bull, but be careful because you know I get palpitations on the Red Bull.
Sarah, the last time she had Ron Carew, well, I don't think I've ever laughed more in my entire life. We were at Top of the Pops, and Sarah was doing the Running Man on the dance floor on her own, and Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson, you know the Thriller dance? And she was just, and then she had a come down off the thing, and she was sitting, we were supposed to go out afterwards, and she was sitting hanging over the stair and freaking out. She just didn't know what was going on.
We're going for the Bridget Bardot look today, so.
Directly wrong.